In this demonstration, we are brazing 1-inch steel tubing to 3/4-inch steel tubing using the SSF-6 silver solder and an oxyacetylene torch. Make sure the steel is clean before starting the brazing process, and always broadly heat the area to be brazed. You can use propane, oxypropane, map gas, oxy-map gas, acetylene, or oxyacetylene. We are looking for the base metal to turn color before we start adding our flux. When welding or brazing, always work in a well-ventilated area. Not adding the rod yet, just painting some flux in place and then heating your base metal to make sure the flux flows out. The parent metal is just ready to turn red. That's when we want to lay in our rod. It flows best at this temperature. Since we do have flux already in place, we can use our torch to push and pull the existing filler metal around the tube. And on this side of the tube, we're mainly just going to add some more flux. As long as you have the flux there, you can grab some of that filler metal and just pull it around. Just like that. This same rod works on brass, bronze, cast iron, stainless steel, chrome-moly, on and on, at 70,000 PSI. And take a look at the way this product finishes. We did not sand it or grind it. That's what it looks like when you put it on a wire wheel. Businesses and maintenance workers are using the SSF-6 more and more these days, as it's easy to use on site. The rod is very strong, and it finishes much better than MIG welding. If you need more strength, just add more rod. Now, anyone with a propane torch can look as good or even better than your local welder using the SSF-6 silver solder.